Well, thank you everyone for joining. A really exciting conversation. It's exciting for all of y'all to come, and I'm really excited who we're going to have a conversation with. Richard Rusczyk, who I think for almost all of y'all needs really no introduction.
Well, thank you very much. Thanks. I'm thrilled to be here. And I got to tell you a story I haven't told you before, I don't think, Sal, is when you got started and you were really starting to take off with Khan Academy, I turned to Dave Patrick, who this might have been this was 2009, 2010, something along pretty early on in your growth trajectory. And I'm like, hey, Dave, you know, should we be worried about this Khan Academy thing, you know, because maybe that's going to be big competition. And Dave said, no, we don't have to be worried about Sal succeeding. We have to be worried about him failing because he's carrying the banner for online education. So I want to thank you personally for not failing and for carrying the banner for online education so well.
Art of problem solving, I've never felt kind of a competition with, because it's so complementary to what we're trying to do. And it's such a rich spectrum. I have my own kids. You know, we have the whole collection of Art of Problem Solving books. We do problems together on it all the time. So I think these are very complementary efforts that we're doing. But I will take the privilege of starting asking Richard a few questions that I've always wanted to ask him. You know, Richard, when you were the winner of the US Math Olympiad, I mean, what was your mindset going into this? Was this one of those things? I remember going to some of these math competitions when I was young and always feeling like, wow, like, am I going to be able to do well here? Did you have those feelings? Did you have feelings of insecurity? And then how did you kind of get through those?
Oh, absolutely. When the first time I went to the Math Olympiad program, that's the training program for what will eventually be the U.S. team. I was a sophomore from Northern Alabama. I didn't know anyone else who had ever gone to this. So I had figured that I was just the smartest person in the world. So then I get to the Math Olympiad program and you're there for 5 weeks. You have a practice test every other day. It's three or four problems, three or four hours. So I'm there. I see probably 60 or 70 problems on practice tests. And I got exactly none correct. Not a single one. So I was definitely not the smartest person in the world. So I go home. The next year I practice, I work really hard. I had the stack of formula sheets and I was so sure what I really needed to do was know more math. I was going to learn more math like those other people knew. So my stack got bigger. I knew all the formulas. I was going to show them what I could do. I got back to the training camp my junior year and I showed them what I could do. I still couldn't do any of the problems. Did not get a single problem the second year either. It was the third year when I went back and I took my stack and I took out the first sheet. And I'm like, why is this true? Why is this true? Why is this true? And realized I didn't know why. And it was that year, spending that year asking myself, why are these things true? That I think I first started really doing math and first started really thinking about the process of creating knowledge instead of just ingesting knowledge. And I think that was the transition that made me able to do some of these Olympiad problems. Certainly when I sat down for that test, I was terrified. I'm like, I'm not going to get any, just like I usually don't get any. But that transition really paid off, that change of focus. And I think that's something that we really bring out in when we're teaching is trying to help other students through that shift.
So you must have been understanding a lot of math intuitively. So what was kind of the difference?
The set of facts I knew I could apply to problems that were close to things I had already seen. It's just when it got a little bit farther away and I had to create tools that I would need to solve those problems. Mm-hmm. So it was that the competitions maybe before I got to, say, the Olympiad level, the tools that I had memorized, I could apply to enough of those problems to get through and I could get by. But then when you get to like proof mathematics, why is this true? It's a different mindset. You can't just throw everything you have at it and gut through a lot of the problems the way you can, say, the first few levels of competition. You have to have a deeper understanding. And I didn't have that when I was earlier on in my studies.
And then what was that aha moment where you're like, not only am I starting to get these right, but you know,
you get to college and you see that these skills transfer. And I think that's probably part of why you started with mathematics when you were teaching is math is a great way to train people how to think, how to approach problems. And then you can take that skill and transfer it to other things. So I found that my physics classes, chemistry, computer science, philosophy, economics, all of these things, I could use the same general strategies to work through my college classes. So I had a huge advantage coming into college that a lot of students didn't have. To me, the thing that keeps me up at night is a concern that we are not reaching our potential in education, in art of problem solving, personal potential. And working with this set of students that we work with, like that's the goal, is to help them be able to realize their potential, because these kids have such amazing, amazing potential. Because when there's COVID 2049, who's going to get us out of that mess? It's the kids that are in this room right now.
We've always had this kind of mutual respect for each other. And as we talked about earlier, we always thought it was incredibly complementary in what Khan Academy does and what Art of Problem Solving does. I think there's a couple of areas that we would love to see collaboration with both the orgs and frankly, with the communities. One area is we want all of y'all to seriously think about leveraging the schoolhouse.world platform, one, to give back to other people, because I'm guessing almost all of y'all are either already amazing tutors or could develop into being a really amazing tutors of other people, and you'll feel really good about that.
You talked earlier about the complementary nature of Khan Academy and AoPS, and I think that's exactly right. That was evidenced by when we made the announcement that we were going to have this session today, is seeing the number of kids posting on Art of Problem Solving that, you know, they have spent so much time in both spaces, you know, that they found so much in both places, and that we can find more ways to make that happen. So we see on our site, the kids create sessions for each other all the time. They're trying to teach, they're trying to create, you know, they create separate, and sometimes they're getting together on other chat services or something to run little classes, or now on video. Schoolhouse gives them a very nice platform to do that.